Hello, friends. This is Soft Reason. In this lesson, I will be taking you on roofing structure and as well the roofing sheet. Okay, just like this. Okay, we will be looking at how to place our rafter, just like this, and as well as our batting, which is as well known as the polines. Okay, and also we also look at how to actually place this tie beam, okay, under it, this one, okay. All right, so if I go to the rendering 3D, okay, if I go to this place, at the end of the video we will be able to render, okay, we'll be able to render to have something of this kind. Okay, this is the step tiles roof, and then the wooden structure of the roof. Okay, so if you have not subscribed, the only way you can support this channel for the effort we are putting to provide for you a lesson is to subscribe. So you subscribe and stay tuned. Okay, so let's start. All right, friends, this is a new project, okay, new architectural template project. Okay, so I will start immediately. So I will go to roof just like this, okay, and then I want to design this roof at level 2. Okay, so I click on yes. Okay, so I will pick this rectangular 2, okay, to model my roof. Okay, so I will zoom in, and then I'll be able to click, and then I'll have a roof of 9 meter by 4 meter, just like this. Okay, I have something of this kind, then I click on finished. Okay, all right, so see, I've click on finished. Okay, since I click on finish, you will not see it because I'm drawing, I modeled the roof on level 2 while I am on level 1. Okay, so I have to activate level 2. Okay, so I'll now have this. Okay, let me activate fine. Okay, all right, so maybe if I activate shade, you will have something of this kind. Okay, so if I go to 3D, I will be having my roof just like this. Okay, all right, so the next thing we will do is I will select this roof, okay, just like this, and then I'll come to this place, and then I'll select slope glazing. Alright, so we will be using this cutting wall to form the wooden structure. So after selecting this slope glazing, I will come to this slope glazing just like this, and I will give it a name, okay, duplicate it, alright, and call it rafter. Okay, rafter. Okay, just let me just say rafter board. Okay, just like this, rafter board. Okay, so I click on okay. So after which I want to edit this pattern, okay, the cutting wall panel. I will edit this place, and then I'll make it empty. Okay, this place of joint definitions will be none. Okay, so the grid one, okay, this grid one, I want to use a maximum spacing. I will use 400 here. Okay, just like this. Okay, then I'll come to this million grid one, select this place, and then I want to use this 50 by 150. Okay, the same thing. Yeah, 50 rectangular millions, 50 by 150, and also this same thing here. All right, just like this. Okay, so after which I click on okay. All right, so if I click on OK, you will see that you have something of this kind. Okay, all right, so this is the rafter. Okay, and so we want to proceed. I want to go to this place, architectural template. Okay, then I want to use this millions. Okay, this one. So if I click on it, so let me deselect this command first. All right, so I will be having something of this kind. Okay. If I turn it, I rotate it, you see it very well, okay, just like this, okay. This is my rafter, okay. So if I go to this million, I want to put this ridge, okay. So I will click on this million, okay. I will click on this place, and then I will be able to check this angle to 30 degree, okay, yeah, and then I will have here 25. I want to make here to be 10 instead of 25. Okay, 10. Okay, and this place will be 10. Okay, just like this. Okay, and then click on apply it and okay. All right, so if I click on apply, okay, I can be able to place it at this reach level position. So I click there to place it. That is it. Okay, all right, meaning the rafter we are connected to this one. Okay, so that is it. Alright, so after which I will view the project in some other view, or go to the east view, okay, of the project is something of this kind. Okay, so I will select this one just like this, and then copied it. I pick it from this point and replace it somewhere here. Okay, just like this. All right, so after which I will go back to the 3D. After which I want to actually have a edit this so I can have a button size. If I click on this one, now I can now click on edit. Okay, this is million, mind you, this is million. So I want to duplicate this million, and then I'll give it a name as button. Okay, buttons. Okay, just like this. Click on okay, then the angle I will make it 0 degree. Alright, so this size, this place, I'll make it 25. Okay, here I will make this place 25, then I'll make here 25. Okay, just like this. I click on okay, so it actually changed this particular place. Okay, but I will click on this point and then I will select this one, so it will go back to its original position. Okay, so I supposed to give this one a name. Okay, supposed not to be rectangular 50 by 50. Okay, I supposed to give it a name as a ridge. Okay, supposed to give it a name as a ridge. All right, so the next thing we will be doing is we want to actually delete this one. Okay, so how do we do that? So we try to select one of these member. Okay, just like this, you right click and then you select millions. Okay, so you select the O's. Okay, millions on O's, so you just click on that, so all will be selected. So you click on this to delete it. Okay, so it's not actually responding, so we can't now select this. This is rafter bot. Click on edit, and then you come to this point. Okay, and then you click here, you select none. Okay, click this place, select none, just like this. Okay, select none, also select none here, click on apply it. Okay, and then click on this. and then you click on OK. So once you have this one, so you just have to click to delete this one. Okay, this menu one. Can click this right click and then you can select the host. They click on delete now. They are all deleted, so you don't have anyone here. Okay, so what you need to do is this is a this is a rafter board, so let us undo. Okay, so this is a rafter board. Before you delete them, you will have to select this just like this. Click on this place, edit, okay, and then duplicate it. You have to duplicate it. We duplicate it by giving it a name. We want to call that a polyline, okay? Polyline, just like this. Click on OK. All right. After which, you click on OK. Right, just like this. So after duplicating it, you're having polylines now, so you click here and then you can now start to change the orientations. Okay, we'll make this place known, also make here known, also make here known. Okay, just like this, click on apply, then click on this. And then you okay, so after which you can now select this and then click right click and then select a select million host just like this, and then you can't delete. Okay, all right, so we have deleted, and then you see we make this cutting roof empty, so you select it just like this, and then you go back to the edit tab. This time around we will be using the grid lines too. Okay, this grid lines too, we will be using a fixed distance just like this. A fixed distance fixed space distance we'll be using a 200, okay, just like this. And then the grid millions, we're using grid lines 2 billions. Okay, so I will select buttons. You know, we set buttons in that millions. Okay, so select buttons here, then come to this place and then select buttons, come to this place also, select buttons, the one we set, okay, in the previous lesson. Okay, so just like this. Okay, so I click on apply it, and then I will click on okay, so you'll be having something of this kind. Okay, so this is the buttons. So okay, well arranged. Alright, so we want to place the buttons over this over the polylines. Okay, we want to place the button over the polylines. So we'll go to the east view. Okay, just like this. So after which we will click on this buttons. Okay, click on it just like this.
And then click on move.
Click on move, and then we'll be able to move it over this one. Okay, we'll be able to move it over this one like this. Okay, and we will try to put it in place. Okay, still select it. All right, we still select it using the arrow key on the keyboard. Okay, we'll use the arrow key on the keyboard just like this. You move it until it is right on top of the polyline. Sorry, this right on top of the rafter, just like this. Okay, so afterwards you cannot check it in 3D, so you will be having something of this kind. Okay, alright, so after having something of this kind, we can go to the floor plan. Okay, and then we'll try to do a section just like this. For try to do a section like this, okay. Try to do a section like this, all right. And also, we want to give the roof its normal color, okay. We want to give the roofing structure this wood's color, okay. So we'll select one of this one, okay. Select one of this one. We'll try to zoom in, okay, and then be able to. Let's go to the 3D, okay. Zoom in. Try to select one of these just like this, okay. After which, you click on this edit, okay. This one. Alright, so you will be having a material and finishings, okay. So you have an aluminium here, so click on this point, okay, to navigate to the material. So in the material dialog, we will create a new material, okay, and then click on this, or we can just leave this aluminium, okay. Then we come to this and then use render appearance, okay. Come to this render appearance, and then we'll be able to select any material, or you come to this point. Once you select that point, okay, you can just pick this appearance, okay, and then you navigate to navigate to wood, okay. You choose this wood panel, so you can select any of this, any of this wood panel material. Okay, so once you select it, close this point, okay, come to this place and click, so it will take you to where the materials are. All right, so in this dialog, you can now navigate to select the right wooden material you want to actually used, okay. So I want to select one here, okay. So we will select this one, this material, okay. Click on open. Alright, so the material will be loaded under aluminium, okay. But if we want to change the name of this material, we can just come to this place and then click on create new material, okay, just like this. Once you click on it, right click, and then you rename it, you can give it a name as a wooden material, okay. So just type something like this, okay, wooden material, okay, just like this, okay. Can change here. All right, just like this. Once you give it a name, you come to graphics, use a render appearance, okay, just like this, and then you can be able to look for the material, that same material, okay. So it will not be under the you know, so it will not be under aluminium, okay, because it's a wooden material. So can just use this one with sharing it on it, okay. So you just click to apply it there, okay. So after which, close this one, okay, just like this, and then click on apply it. After you apply it, you just click on okay. So we're having this as our material. Click on apply it, and then you click on okay. All right, so you will be having something of this kind. If you check this shaded, okay, you have this. All right, so this is how you can, you know, apply your material. So the next stage of the lesson is, we'll go to the let's go to the level 2, having our section, okay. We'll go to this section 1 and open it, so you'll be having this, okay. So I want to go to architectural tab, Then I want to model in place, okay. Then I will scroll to down to roof, click on it, and then give it a name as tie, okay. Just like this, and then click on okay. So I will use extrusion, pick a plane, okay. I will have to move my cursor around here to see I have something like this, because I see the face is being highlighted, so I click, I use that as my work plane, okay. If I click, I click on this place to show up plane, you can see that is my work plane, okay. So I can now pick a point. I want it to the time to be in this place, okay. So I can't, okay, have this, all right. Then I'll click on modify, okay. So I want to offset this, so I can now click on offset. I'm setting it at 125, okay, below, just like this. And then I can pick point now, then pick this line. I can also pick this one just like this, and then I will be able to just do a trimming, okay. Trim it this way, trim it this way, and then this way, just like this. I'll remove this, and then the depth I will be using 100, okay. Click on okay. So I'll have something of this kind, okay. So if I go to D3D like this, I'll have, this is my tie beam here, okay. So what I will do is I'll go to the south elevation, okay. If you have not activated your own, click here to activate it. So I click on finished, okay. I'll be having this, so I can change this material, okay. Click on it, edit this extrusion, click on this again, then come to this point, see the category by category, click on it, and then you'll be able to select this wooden material, which is the material we have set. Click on okay to apply it, and then click on finished. You have the material. So I'll go to the south elevation. If I go to the south elevation, you will notice that this is the tie beam, okay. This is the tie beam. I'll click on it, I can adjust it if I wish, all right. So it will not be too much, supposed to be 50, okay. So I have something of this kind, I can copy it, okay. I click on copy and select multiple, okay. So I can pick this point and then be able to place it just like this, okay. And I'll continue to place it along this, just like this. So this one is my tie beam, okay. Although it is very close to the it's very close to the droplets of the roof, but in your own case you can bring it somewhere here, okay. This is just for the sake of a lesson, okay. For the sake of lesson, so just like this. All right, so I believe and I hope you understand how to fix that, okay. All right, so if I go to my 3D now, you see that this is my tiling, okay. Look at it there. All right, so the next thing is to place the roofing sheet, okay. So for us to do that, you go to the level 2 just like this, and then you go to architectural tab, select the roof, okay. So once you select the roof, want to use this one, rectangular roof, okay. Then I want to have an offset of let's say 100, okay. So I will pick I'll actually pick this point, pick a point here, okay. The offset of 100 is too much, okay? So I will pick again and then be able to choose the offset to be 50. Just like this, okay? And then I will start from somewhere here, click. It's this adjustable, I can adjust it later, okay? So, and then I'll bring it to somewhere this point. Somewhere this point and click, just like this, okay? So if you want to bring it down, you can just select this one, use the arrow key to bring it closer, okay? Just like this, okay? Do the same thing here. You do the same thing here. Okay, so you can also do the same thing here. Just like this. Using the arrow key. Alright. Then this is okay like this. After which you just have to finish it like this. So once you finished it like this, if you come to this place, you can change the thickness of the roof, okay? You can change the thickness of the roof to 200. I want to use 200. Then I'll go to this structural material, okay? So I want to create a material, okay? Or I can select a material in this place. If I type here roof, okay, I'll be able to see material related to roof, okay? So if I scroll down, see this roof tile, okay, I'll select it, click on this point, come to this point to see the roof tile, which is this one, okay? So I can just click on this, double click here to have this. So once I have this, I want to make it more visible, okay, for me to do that. I'll make this place 4500, okay, so it will automatically change in this place. Click on done, okay? So after which can click on apply it. The grossness, I can just increase it a little bit, okay? Click on apply it and then click on okay, just like this. Then okay, yeah, apply it here and okay. All right so I will be having something of this kind. So if I go to the 3D, this is what I'll be having, okay? I will be having something of this kind, okay? So what I want to do, I want to open this top of this roof, okay? I want to open the top of this roof. So for me to do that, I'll be using roof by face, but by then I'll go to the level 2 like this, click on roof by face, okay? Select this roof by face, okay? Use a circle, which is what you see in my thumbnail, okay? So I'll have something like this. Click on finished to create that, okay, which is this one, okay? So after which I will navigate to the 3D. I have something like this. I can now go to the east elevation. I will select this roof just like this. I can move it up, select this roof, move it up using the move icon, okay? And move it up just a little bit to some extent like this, okay? So I can jump, I can bring it down a little bit, just like this, and then I'll go to the 3D, and I'll have something of this kind, okay? Have something of this kind. I go back to the east view. And then I move this one so it can be visible just like this, okay? So I want to render it now. All right so because if I don't render it, you may not be able to see the tile, the roof tile, okay? So for me to do that, come to this point, click on this icon, render, okay? And then I click on region. All right so I'll be able to adjust this a little bit to fit the rendering portion, okay? Just like this, just like this. All right so after which I will come to print, come to this point, 300, and there I will use medium. Okay, so after which few clouds, that is the little adjustment I can do. Click on render. So after you finish rendering, you will be having something of this kind. Okay, you will be having something of this kind. Okay, so this brings us to the end of this presentation. Do it to support the channel by subscribing if you are new to the channel. Bye for now.